One thing all satellites and spacecraft need is fuel, right? But what happens if you can move a vehicle in space without fuel? That's what Astrum Drive Aerospace is working on, a propellant-less propulsion system. Their system, which is under development, is described on their website as propellant-less, electricity-only space propulsion system. If this system can be shown to work, then it would be a breakthrough, leading to spacecraft without any onboard fuel. Their system has progressed to technology readiness level 6 and 7, with multiple patents filed and some ground testing completed. Astrum believes their propulsion system can unlock scalable in-space logistics, orbital servicing, and deep space exploration, reshaping the economics of the global space industry, in their words. So, there is good and bad news about this startup. First, let's look at the good news and explore how this propulsion system could enable new missions in orbit and deep space. Benefits of propellant-less propulsion. A propulsion system that does not expend fuel could accelerate continuously, as long as it has a power source. Astrum claims that their propulsion system could reach most planets in under a year, enabling rapid logistics, scientific discovery, and entirely new mission possibilities. Fuel is a large fraction of the mass of spacecraft and satellites. Without fuel, the craft is lighter, or perhaps can carry more payloads instead. In terms of commercial missions, the company lists satellite station keeping, space tug and debris operations, and lifetime extension missions. Lab testing. Astrum have conducted tests in a vibration-isolated environment with no airflow. The test system was placed on a highly sensitive scale and produces downward-directed thrust, which results in a measurable increase in its apparent weight. This prototype system generated, on average, 12 millinewtons of continuous thrust when operating at full power. To eliminate any lateral motion, the system is securely tied at the top. This limits the measurable thrust to about 12 millinewtons, which is still thousands of times greater than the background noise and the scale's margin of error. Field testing. Astrum concluded a free-fall test using helium balloons to nearly cancel the system's weight, bringing it down to just a few grams. This makes the thrust generated by the device sufficient to create visible motion. In another test, they dropped the system from a height of 50 centimeters. That's about 1.5 feet. The drop times when the system is off compared to when the system is on are different. The shorter drop times when the system is active clearly indicate the presence of additional downward force generated by the propulsion system. Technology. The thrust is generated by phase changes in superfluid helium-4, resulting in directed force without expelling mass. I've included a link to their peer-reviewed article called Non-Combustion Helium-4 Power Propulsion in the video description. The paper proposes a closed-cycle system using helium-4 high-pressure gas that expands into a pipe in cold space. This causes a phase transition to superfluid helium due to the low pressure and temperature, which allegedly reduces the outward momentum of the exhaust while allowing liquefied helium to be recycled back via pumps powered by electricity. Helium in its superfluid phase has zero friction and with a phase change is able to create asymmetric thrust without mass expulsion. This paper relies entirely on simulations to support its drive concept. However, this falls far short of what is needed for a robust validation. It's worth noting that the journal is open access and relatively low prestige in the engineering field. Without any physical testing, its mechanism is unproven and appears to violate fundamental laws of physics. It's generally well understood that in an isolated system, net thrust can only occur with mass ejection. While helium superfluid properties are interesting, there's no reason to think they would violate the laws of conservation and momentum. An orbital demo would be essential to overcome these concerns. Simulations alone do not provide proof to override established conservation laws. LinkedIn Rebuttal, Detailed Analysis, Astrum Drive Helium-4 Propulsion Page. There's a detailed analysis of Astrum Drive's propulsion system that I've linked to in the video description. It's by Harry P. Strain. who is the CEO of a competing propulsion system called Quantum Dynamics Enterprises. In summary, he has concerns with Astrum Drive's technology. He lists a number of fundamental problems, which are claims to release momentum as heat, which is impossible, he states, violates conservation of momentum, no constraint testing validation, based on debunked helium-4 paper physics, and cannot work in reality. In his critique, the central issue is that Astrum Drive claimed to convert excessive momentum into space as heat. The momentum conservation law states that the total momentum of a closed system remains constant. You cannot release excessive momentum into space as heat. Heat is energy, not momentum. He goes on to list the impossible physics claims by Astrum, which are: closed cycle, we release nothing into space. The reality is you cannot generate thrust without expelling mass momentum. Direct conversion from electricity to motion. This violates Newton's third law of motion without reaction mass. He also disputes the performance claims. Astrum claim a thrust of 1 newton. That's 1,000 millinewtons. Sprain suggests this would require massive power and that there is no mechanism shown for 1 newton of thrust from helium-4 phase transitions. Sprains also claims that 95% payload is impossible without reaction mass, and Astrum system violates rocket equation fundamentals. Well, his conclusions are damning. I'm no physicist, so have no technical opinion to give. From what I can find online, there are no known mechanisms for net thrust in closed systems without mass expulsion. Comparison with EM drive. Both the Astrum drive and the EM drive claim propellant-less propulsion, although they use different physics to achieve this, so are different from a technical perspective. But they are similar in the claims of having invented a closed-loop system that doesn't need reaction mass. Both argue that novel physics allows this without violation. Both drives are controversial, with physicists doubting their viability, since they appear to violate fundamental laws. They both rely on lab reports that generate tiny amounts of thrust, which could be caused by measurement artifacts or unaccounted forces. Neither have undergone orbital testing, which is a critical test for evaluating if these drive systems work. The consensus in the physics community is that the EM drive doesn't work and violates conservation laws. There has been no widespread independent testing of the Astrum drive yet, so criticism is leveled at the momentum conservation issue. How credible is Astrum Drive's claim? Skepticism is warranted. It's possible unknown environmental effects were not eliminated and could be producing very small amounts of thrust observed. Until this drive is tested in space and produces thrust, it's probably best to be skeptical. Let's hope they can finance an orbital validation test in the future, as a propellant-less propulsion system would be amazing and would be helpful in many in-space activities, such as satellite servicing, refueling, orbital debris removal, and many other tasks as well. The company also has a page on their website on warp research, including developing stable warp bubble solutions and negative energy. I've looked at plenty of space startup websites before, and this is the first time I've seen exotic propulsion systems like this mentioned. I don't think it adds credibility to include warp research on your website when many people will be skeptical of your propulsion system to begin with. Upcoming events. The company is currently attempting to raise $7 million for a space demonstration of their system. On their invest page, they talk about their system opening up opportunities in space mining, space tourism, and more. With funding secured, they aim for a space demonstration in 2027, followed in 2028 by sales with hundreds of units per year. What do you think of Astrum Drive's propellant-less propulsion system? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week, or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with previews of upcoming content. If you got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.